Life has a funny way of guiding us, often in directions we never thought possible. It all started with a dream filled with endless possibilities. You are right, Mrs. Hammond. My father used to say that I was like a kaleidoscope. Ideas and ambitions that dance through my mind, like fireflies in the night. Oh no, not at all. I have always been a multifaceted soul, you see, with a curious mind and a stubborn heart. Thank you, gentlemen, for your time. The world seemed so vast, and I felt lost within its immensity. I felt the same way. I wanted to be a writer, an artist, a farmer, a baker, a professor, a bookseller. And I am probably forgetting something else. I think you were right, Papa. My soul can never be content if I pick just one of my many sides. It was during those challenging times that I discovered the beauty of old, timeless things. Do you remember when we used to seek solace, walking around markets and talking to sellers and collectors? And then, one day, the idea just came to me. Fret now, dear Papa. Even if I had to take on several sideshows and scrape by to save for my dream, I have been given the loan now. You might have heard people refer to me as the Vintage Shopkeeper, but you might be wondering what exactly this place is. I called my shop the Timeless Treasures Boutique, a place that transports you back in time, yet plants seeds for a brighter future. From collectible pieces to poetry readings, from natural cosmetics to tea and cake, my shop will have it all. I like to see it as a place where the past meets the future, where every item has a story, and every day is a new chapter waiting to be written. Welcome to my shop. Can't you believe it, Papa? The grand opening was a success. I started very early in the morning. Despite spending weeks on preparations, there was still plenty to do. But the shelves are now filled with treasures I've collected over the years, and many more than products that are a delight for body and soul. I was able to acquire a wide range of natural cosmetics, art supplies, candles, and all the pretty things you can imagine I would have. My first visitor was sweet errand boy. Some good friends of mine sent me a box with some useful things. They have been very supportive, and they will even come for the first poetry reading at the end of the week.
Thank you.
Papa, I know many would say that I have been working excessively to attain perfection. But I always wanted this place to be more than a mere shop. I want my boutique to be a pioneer, a place that inspires others to look beneath the surface. Prior to the opening, fear clung to my heart like a cloud, capable of overshadowing my excitement and ideas. You taught me to listen to my heart, and deep down, I knew this was the right thing for me, but uncertainty crept in nonetheless. It was then that I remembered your words. When we try our best, no matter the outcome, the reward is always proportional to the effort. And I am glad to say that I shall never have cause for regret that I lacked the courage to try. And then, as the sun broke through the windows, the timeless Thresher's boutique was ready to welcome its first visitors.
Such lovely antiques. Oh, this is fascinating. Timeless elegance, indeed. Oh dear, unique and enchanted treasure. I see now by the corner of Vintage Shopkeeper. Oh, Mrs. Pauly, exquisite taste.
Customers arrived, complimented my products and intrigued by this new idea. As you used to say, the treasures some people grew tired of have found a sanctuary here and will be cherished once more. I wish I could tell you every detail, but you won't be able to see it all on your next visit. For now, you'll just have to picture it all. As I showed each item, talked to each customer, and rubbed each product, I couldn't help but think that this is and will be much more than just a shop. It is a place for community and culture, and an opportunity to slow down and enjoy a cup of tea or coffee among friends, old and new.
Thank you.
What is called? You have eggs or something. Oh, my grandmother used to have one.
Visitors came not only as shoppers, they also seemed interested in taking books home and attending the poetry readings. Some of the ladies had never seen the books I have here, but I am so glad I do, Papa. They are so inspiring in the fight for a better world. Time flew by, and just as in the early hours of the morning, I found myself alone in the quietness of my shop. Oh, Papa, I do not want to sound hasty, but can you imagine what it will look like when I decorate my shop for Christmas? Pine branches, orange slices, and holly berries all around my shop. I cannot help but feel that you will be proud of me. My heart is full and my spirit alive. It seems this kaleidoscope has finally shone in all its colors. And this is just the beginning.